Hello, Advanced Dragons! Welcome to week 7. Oh my gosh. 7 of quarantine or online karate. This month, alright, it's a new month. We're working on focus and respect. So, to get started, we're going to do a couple drills associated with focus, keeping our eyes in front of us and on our targets, but we're also going to warm up at the same time. So, what I ask is that you guys grab, let's see, hold on a moment.
Okay, so I feel like it's important that we start off our push-ups young. So you guys need a piece of paper and you need a marker. And let me put you guys lower so you can see, okay?
I'm going to put my paper down and my marker I'm going to put
under my chin.
All right? And as they come down, all right, I'm going to make a target. X in the middle of my paper. You guys see? After that, I'm going to put my marker under my chin. We don't want to put them in our mouths because it's gross. And I'm going to try my best to line myself up and draw the X. Alright?
My dot is here. My X is here. So did I make my target? No, so I have to readjust and really, truly focus.
Let's see. Ready? Oh, this time I got above it. Everybody do this with me. Oh my goodness, I got it!
See? There's Miss Alli's X. And that little stray dot right there is where I got it. All right, so I want you guys to get a piece of paper, to get a marker. You're going to put the marker under your chin.
Uncap it. Don't get it on your face. And you're going to go in a push-up position, but you're going to look at your target. X marks the spot. And try and dot the center of the target. All right, go practice.
So, if you attempted that challenge, wonderful. I want us to work on our push-ups, though, because that's something that I think we all need to strive to do better than, because a lot of you will do your push-ups like this. That's not a push-up. A lot of you will do your push-ups with your butt in the air, and like this. That's not a push-up, all right? I'm going to get a pillow, all right, my pillow pet. I'm going to put it under me, all right? My goal is, I know I had you guys looking down to dot the X, but that's because I wanted you to focus on your target. What I want you guys to do is look in front of you. So I'm in my push-up position, okay? My chest needs to touch and come back up, all right, as soon as possible. Just like reaction speed we worked on last month. So I'm going to focus on a target, which is right in front of me. So I'm going to make an imaginary X, all right? And I'm going to look up. Ready? I'm going to go down and come up, all right? My goal is to get my arm super-duper low. This is not a push-up. These are not push-ups, all right? You want to go low. Low. You guys got it? So, I want you guys to do, we're going to do 10 together, but we'll do them slow. But I want you guys to work on your target, or focusing, all right? Focusing on your technique and what your body is doing. Because, again, we're not focused. And if we just blindly go into the, oh, I say, Miss Ice. I say, everybody get in a push-up position, and some of you are like this. Some of you are like this. Well, you're not really focusing on what I'm telling you to do, because you're lazy. So we're not going to be lazy. We're going to get in a push-up position, and we're really going to focus on what parts of our body are in check with our push-up. Boom. Boom, all right? Our target is the pillow, our chest is the weapon, and our eyes are forward. All right, so let's do 10 together. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Are you guys low enough? You getting there? 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yeah. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
So, don't mind me, I'm not wearing my glasses right now, so I can't see you guys once I'm over there. But, we're working on focus this month. So, what's gonna happen is, I'm gonna draw an X. All of my strikes have to line up with this X. Because we're working on focus. And we need to make sure, alright? We have an idea of where our target is. We're looking at our target. So, along with my X, I'm gonna draw two eyes. So everybody go get a piece of paper and a marker. I'll pause here so that you guys can join me. So, get a marker. Obviously, if I'm using a pad and my paper has two layers, so it's not gonna bleed through. Don't do this without your parents. Get something like maybe like cardboard and a marker, or get like a crayon, something that won't bleed through. And won't get on the walls, because that would be a disaster in itself. So get a cardboard and a Sharpie, or get paper and like colored pencils or something, and then come back to me. What I'm gonna do is draw. So this is gonna be our tool for class today. All right, I'm gonna draw two eyes. So everybody draw eyes. All right. Everybody better be drawing their eyes with me. Good. And then maybe like some type of face. I'll make a silly face. Okay. That's my face. All right. I have to be looking at this target throughout the whole entire class. You guys got it? All right. So that's what's happening. We're going to start with action karate form 3. So I'm going to line myself up with my target, okay? So, I'm in a horse stance, all right? From here, I don't have to do this mirror image now, so I'm just thinking of how to do it. All right, so with my right hand, I'm gonna strike. Boom. Boom, do this with me, with your people. Boom. Back fist, step forward, punch. Descending back fist, spin back fist. Twist and punch, turn the foot. Roundhouse kick, chop, all right? Hold on, listen to the next clip. So my little guy or girl or person thing is not lined up with my eyes, because I'm taller than the pad, surprisingly. So what I want you guys to do is line the face that you just made up with your eye level. I'm sorry, I should have said that earlier. Do that. So it's like, because when we do our self-defenses later, we're looking at someone, ideally when we practice these self-defenses, someone at our own height. So I don't want you to practice it with it lower than you. So I only did that because I have that resource for me. But try and get it so it's eye level. Okay, so now that your opponent is eye level, all right? Well, I can probably do that now. Hold on. All right? Action karate form 3. We're doing it again. Ready? Horse stance. Scoop. Plah. Scoop. Plah. Pull back. Back fist, step forward, punch. I'm making eye contact. Aya! Turn the foot, kick, chop. You have your eyes on your target, right? You're not looking at me right now? I hope not. All right, horse stance, look in front of you. Boom, boom. We're doing it again. Ready? Horse stance. Scoop. Plah. Scoop. Plah. Pull back. Back fist. Step forward, punch. I'm making eye contact. Aya. Turn the foot. Kick. Chop. You have your eyes on your target, right? You're not looking at me right now? I hope not. All right, horse stance. Look in front of you. Boom. Boom. Ay-yah! So, you're going to practice your form. Talk through the moves. Look at your target. Focus on what's in front of you. That's what that's there for. Go practice it 5 times and then come back to me. So, next drill. I want you guys to get a bouncy ball of some sort. All right, pause the video right here. Go get that bouncy ball. All right, so what's going to happen is I'm just going to simply start throwing the ball with my back hand and push forward and hit the X every time. 10 times. Ready? 1, 2. All right, I want to see the twist. I don't want you to just go like this. Anybody can do that. I want you guys to twist, throw. Twist, throw. Twist, throw. You have to hit the target every time. Throw. 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 All right, now that you've done that a few times, you're gonna throw up, punch, and hit the target. Throw up, punch, hit the target. Up, punch. Up, punch. Up. Uh-oh, I wasn't very focused. What happened there? Was Miss Alli focused on hitting with the right technique, or was she focused on just hitting the ball? All right, there's a difference between, obviously, I gotta think of an example. Hold on a moment. let's say you're playing baseball, right? Mom and dad are bringing you to your game, and you're thinking about what you're gonna have for dinner afterwards. Is that focus? No. So, if I'm throwing the ball, and I'm thinking about, I wonder when I'm gonna be done doing this. Am I gonna be hitting the target as good as I should? No, all right? I don't want you guys to speed through this. I want you guys to slow it down and truly think about what your body is doing. So, up, boom. Up, boom. Up, boom. All right, we're throwing punches now. Ready? Throw up, punch. All right, I want you to throw it high enough so that you have to think about and focus when it's gonna come out. So watch this. Ready? So I'm gonna throw it up as high as I can. And there you go, I hit my target. I wait, I'm focusing for it to come right in front of my target. Ready? Oops, that was a bad throw. All right, that didn't hit my target at that time, but I'm focusing. I'm waiting for the right time to strike. There we go. All right, that's what I want you guys to do. Have fun with that. Do that as many times as you'd like. I think you should do it 25 times. 25 times. Go, do it.
Alrighty, so in the next clip, I am going to put Indiana Jones theme song in there, and you guys are going to make your form a performance, if that makes sense, because this month is month 4, and normally at the end of May, we'd have our graduations. I do not know what that entails just yet. However, we gotta work on those performance skills and getting our form to that level, so have fun with it. Make your own skit. All right, get in the costume, wear some sunglasses, wear a cowboy hat. Have fun with it. Make a cool video, post it with your Indiana Jones theme song that I will attach right after this clip. But I want to see performance level forms. I don't want you to, excuse me, I have the hiccups. I don't want you to sit in front of the camera and go boom, boom to a song that is action filled, okay? I want you guys to listen to the music. Make your form, do a little couple of tricks if you want, maybe add your self-defense, all right? It's month 4 now, I shouldn't have to go through the form and teach you how to do it. Right now I'm working on skills to enforce and make your form even better. So, if you need to go back to videos to learn it, you need to go back and do that, but if you're someone I have to keep reminding to do certain moves, I shouldn't have to be doing that anymore. You should be able to do this on your own. So, take a look. Let me see your performance and have some fun. All right.
We're gonna do a couple of just sparring techniques. So, get in your sparring gear if you have it. All right. If not, you can do this without the sparring gear. Hold on, I'm gonna plug you guys in so that you don't die, because that would be really sad. Okay. So, what I'm gonna do.
Advanced Dragons, if you have gear, go put it on now and count how long it takes for you to get it on. Make sure you're keeping track of that. All right. So, where did my bounce the ball go?
At first, you're gonna do some free sparring. So, you're gonna bow to your partner. You're gonna touch gloves. You should still have this guy on the wall. You're gonna move around. Just practice throwing a bunch of random techniques. All right, make sure you're moving. Don't throw elbows. Elbows are illegal. Just kicks. All right, throw a couple of techniques. Then, you're gonna get to your ball. All right, speed, focus on your target. Move it quickly. All right, all I want you guys to do is work on moving. All right, if you have a heavy bag, you might want to tape your face to your heavy bag. I want your parents to throw the ball at you. So think of when you're sparring, you have a whole bunch of things hitting you at once, right? Obviously, I can't have you guys partner up with someone right now and feel that. So your parent is going to throw a bouncy ball, a pillow, something at you while you're doing your techniques. Because you're supposed to be focusing on the person, not the technique. So, I don't have anybody to throw this at me right now. But if the ball is coming at me, I should still be able to hit the target and not look at the bouncy ball. Does that make sense? All right? Parents. Your child is going to throw a series of techniques. Make sure they do not stop throwing the technique at the opponent. The whole point of this is not to, I'm going to throw the ball at you, and you know, I want them to focus on their target, all right? They're going to be hitting with a whole bunch of techniques, and you're going to be throwing this ball at them, and that ball is going to simulate someone hitting them in the head, and they have to block while also looking at the target because they're working on focus. They shouldn't be worried about the bouncy ball. They should be worried about hitting their target. So, spend about 10-15 minutes doing that, and that's it for today. Thanks for joining me today. Again, rewind the video. Do these a bunch of times. You should be sweating, and you should be practicing. These are focus drills to get us started with the month and having some fun. So, I hope to see you guys Thursday, or no, I hope to see you guys Wednesday during the Zoom and on Thursday. But, yeah, so let me know if you have any questions. I'll see you guys soon. Bye!
We're also working on respect this month, so treat others the way you want to be treated. So thank mom and dad in some way for being so, so nice and so, so kind and so, so patient with you during this time. I instruct you, this is an order, to write them a card. Yes, you need to make your parents a card, not just with pencil, but with the best markers and crayons and paper you have in your house. And if you don't, you need to go hug them and tell them that you love them right now. Go, go, go. Make them a card. Say, thank you, mom and dad. I love you. Thank you, grandma and grandpa, if they live with you, or if you'd like to mail them a card. All right? go say thank you to someone for being so kind to you and for taking care of you and loving you and be, yes, respect. Say thank you. If they give you dinner, they give you dinner. Obviously, they give you dinner. You say thank you, okay? They wash the dishes for you. You say thank you for that. You need to say thank you for everything that your parents do. Got it? I got my eye on you. Go say thank you. Yeah. Treat others the way you want to be treated. So don't yell at your parents if you guys don't want to be yelled at. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Go say thank you.